In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to push our Profiles REST API project to GitHub. Before we push our project to GitHub, we're going to create an SSH key, which is going to allow us to authenticate with GitHub when we push our project. We're also going to use the same key to authenticate with our server on AWS. So this key will allow us to SSH to our server so that we can set it up and run our application on it. An SSH key is simply just a file on our system which acts as a password that allows us to connect to the services. Let's start by creating an SSH key and then adding it to our GitHub account. So on Windows, we can create an SSH key by using the git bash. If you're on Mac or Linux, you can use the same commands to create an SSH key using the terminal. So to create an SSH key, we simply run the command ssh-keygen. This is going to run the SSH keygen app. You can see that it says generating a public and private RSA key. So we're going to leave this location as default and hit enter. And you can choose an optional passphrase that you need to enter every time you use the key. It adds a bit of extra security in case someone manages to get hold or copy the key off your machine. In this case, I'm just going to leave the passphrase blank, so I don't need to enter it every time that I'm showing you the steps. So hit enter to just leave it blank, and then hit enter when repeating it to leave it blank. You can see that it's now created a new key and it's got this random output here. And the way that it works is it creates two files. One is the ID RSA file, and this is a secret file that you should never share with anyone and you should only keep on your local machine. The second file is a public key. This is the key that you can share with the services that you want to connect to. So for example, we're going to be adding this public key to our GitHub account, and we'll also be adding it to AWS in the future lesson. So now that we've created our key, let's go ahead and open the key in Atom Editor so that we can copy it and then paste it into GitHub. So copy the path location of the public key. That is the key that ends in .pub. And then in the command line or the terminal window, type Atom and then paste the URL of the public key and hit enter. This should open up the key in Atom Editor. So let's wait for that to load. Okay, so Atom Editor is loading here. Okay, so now it's loaded our public key. So this is the key that we're going to share with the services that we want to connect to. So make sure that you're logged into your GitHub account, and then at the top right here, click on your profile and head over to settings. And then we're going to select on the left-hand side, the SSH and GPG keys section. I already have a key here. I'm going to add a new SSH key and we're going to give it a title. I'm just going to call it Mark's Desktop. And then in the key contents, you're going to paste in the content of our public key. And then you're going to hit add SSH key. It will ask you to confirm your password again with GitHub. So I'm going to enter that there. And then it will add the key. You can see that it's created this new key here that's never been used. Okay, so next we're going to create a new project on GitHub that we're going to use to store our project. Go back to the GitHub homepage and click on New Repository. We're going to call this repository profiles-rest-api. We can give it the description as our profiles REST API project. And make sure you do not check the initialize this repository with the README, because we already have a project, so we don't need to initialize a new project. We will just a blank empty Git repository. Click on create repository. And now it will give you these instructions here on how we can push our code to GitHub. So we want this one here, push an existing repository from the command line. You want to make sure that the SSH button here is selected, because there's two options. You can push it via HTTPS, or you can push it via SSH. You can see that the URL changes slightly based on which one you choose. We want to use SSH so we can use our SSH key authentication. All right, so now we're going to go over to our project and we're going to navigate in the Git bash or the terminal window to our project location. So workspace profiles REST API. And now we're simply going to copy and paste this command here. So what this does is it adds the remote settings to our Git repository. So it says git remote add origin. Origin is the default one that you use. So it's the default when you're doing pushes and pulls. So we're going to go and paste that in here and hit enter. And it doesn't return any output, but it did work. And then we type this git bash hyphen u origin master. And what this will do, it's git push hyphen u origin master. What this will do is it will push our contents to our Git repository on GitHub. Paste that in, hit enter, and it may ask you to confirm the authenticity of the host github.com. It should only ask you this the first time that you do it. So type yes and hit enter. You can see that it's pushing out the contents of our application up to GitHub. Okay, great. So now let's go back to the GitHub page and refresh. And it will load all of the files of our project. So these are the entire contents of our project. We're going to be using this GitHub repository to access the code for our project from our AWS server. So AWS is going to pull the code down from GitHub and then run it on the server. All right, so that's how you push the project to GitHub. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this useful, and I'll see you in the next lesson.